Hey you guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel, Peterisms, where I tell stories of my life and just little things that I've learned as I've grown into the person that I am today. And today I'm going to do something different over here. I read two meditation books, one by Melody Beattie, and the other one was the Linda Picone Book of Positive Quotations. But I did not read specifically for this video the meditation from The Language of Letting Go. I just looked at the title of it and I didn't read it this morning. And the reason why was because I wanted to do something different. You know, when I started this channel, my purpose was really to tell stories of my life and things that I had learned over here. And when I read meditations, I kind of share things that I've learned or things that, you know, I've practiced for a long time. But what I originally wanted to do over here was I wanted to tell stories of things I've learned, mistakes I've made, you know, screw-ups I've gone through in life, and or just stories about my family and, you know, my friends and things like that. Because I wanted to inspire and motivate people, and I wanted to share the human experience, you know? And I'm very much a believer that we are, you know, spirits having a human experience. And so I wanted to share that on this channel. Now, I've started doing meditations, I think most of you know that, on a daily basis. And I share bits and pieces of my personal life, but what I would like to do going forward is sharing specific stories of how maybe that meditation applied to me. We're gonna see how this works today, because I don't know if it's gonna work or not. But what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna read the meditation, and then I'm gonna share some personal story. I'm gonna reach back into the recesses of my mind, and I'm gonna find some personal story that relates to whatever the lesson is, to kind of like actualize it for you guys and show how when I learn something, because I do very much believe that life is a learning experience, and that's why we're here. And I believe, you know, that life is kind of like this school that you never graduate from. I say that a lot, that when you learn a lesson, you kind of just go to the next grade and to the next grade and to the next grade, but you never really graduate. And I think that, you know, once I figured that out and I figured out there is no perfect ending and there is no top of the mountain in life, that there's just going to be more lessons that are presented to me, I could kind of relax, you know, and I could kind of realize that all of this stuff that happened to me, the good, the bad, the blessings, the tragedies, all of it was all in this great big purpose to teach me something and to become a better person and to learn through the things that I had, you know, happened to me and the things I've done in my life. And that's really what I think that life is about for me. So I want to read the meditation. Like I said, I have no idea what it's about. And then kind of share some personal stories. So it may take me a second to come up with a personal story. We'll see. I have no idea. So this is January 31st. I cannot believe it is already the last day of January. Can you guys believe it? Asking for what we need. One evening, I was alone, weary and exhausted. I was in the midst of extensive traveling, disconnected from friends and family. I had flown home for the evening, but it seemed like nobody noticed. People were used to me being gone. It was late at night, and I began arguing with God. I'm out there working hard. I'm lonely. I need to know someone cares. You've told me to tell you what I need, and tonight, God, I particularly need the presence of male energy. I need a friend, someone I can trust to care about me in a non-sexual, non-exploitive way. I need to be held. Now, where are you? I lay down on the couch and closed my eyes. I was too tired to do anything but let go. The telephone rang minutes later. It was a former colleague who had since become my friend. "Hey, kid," he said, "you sound really tired and needy. Stay right where you are. I'm going to drive out and give you a foot rub. It sounds exactly like what you need." Half an hour later, he knocked on my door. He brought a small bottle of oil with him and gently massaged my feet, gave me a hug, told me how much he cared about me, then left. I smiled. I received exactly what I asked for. It is safe to trust God. Today I will remember God cares about what I need, especially if I do. You know, okay, so I think this is a really interesting meditation because I think there's a misconception in the world, you know, that I have a personal story for this, that, you know, like God is this, or a higher power or whatever you believe in, you know, it's like this genie that grants wishes. And I think that often when people become disillusioned by a higher power or disillusioned in God or angry at God, it's because we feel that like God or whatever our understanding is of a higher power isn't listening to us or isn't answering, you know, our prayers. I'm glad for Melody Beattie that, you know, she said, "God, I need a male friend," and a male friend called like that. But that's not really how life works, and it isn't really how my life has worked, I would say. Years and years and years ago, you know, I was in a relationship that I wanted, this was like when I was in my 20s, and I really wanted this relationship to work, but it just seemed like we would get together and we would break up, and we would get together and we would break up, and It was not a healthy relationship for either one of us to be in. But I remember I was talking to my mom about it on the phone, and my mother was somebody that was, this woman of strong faith, but I would say, like, intellectually spiritual. And what I mean by that is that she wasn't confined by any religious experience, just one-on-one. In fact, there was a book that she loved, and it was called Living Buddha, Living Christ. And it was talking about, it talked about the similarities between Buddha and Christ. And my mother very much believed in those core principles, you know, of compassion, honesty, love, kindness. Those are things I believe in today. When I think about a higher power, I don't necessarily know what my higher power looks like. I don't necessarily know where my higher power resides. But I do know that my higher power wants the best for me. I do know that my higher power, I believe this, okay? I mean, I might find out at the end of the world that there's nothing, okay? And I could be completely wrong. But I like to believe, let me say it that way. I like to believe that my higher power wants the best for me, that my, you know, higher power wants me to learn from the experiences that I go through and not just to stay stagnant. If that were the case, life would be easy. And I believe very much that, you know, my higher power often grants my wishes or gives me what I want or need, but kind of in blessings in disguise sometimes. So I was talking to my mom as this was going on, and I was talking to her about this relationship. And so anyway, she was somebody that believed in these core principles. And I said to her, I said, you know, mom, like, I'm so frustrated with this. Like, I'm really, like, angry, and I'm feeling not very spiritual right now. And she said, well, why are you not feeling spiritual? And I said, I have been praying for this relationship to work. Like, I have been praying so hard. I've been putting all of my positive energy into it. I really believe this is a relationship, you know, for me to be in and things like that. And my mom said to me, she goes, no, she goes, we don't pray for things like that. We don't pray to win the lottery. We don't pray for a relationship. We don't pray for, you know, a new car, new house, things like that. She said, we pray for things like compassion or understanding or tolerance. You know, we pray for the endurance to get through tough times, you know, or if I'm not granted a relationship, allow me to learn who I'm supposed to be alone. She goes, those are the things that we pray for. She said, you know, like, God doesn't just grant wishes. Like, that's not what God's about. You know, God is about teaching us and helping us through these difficult times. And I started looking at it in a completely different way at that point, you know? And it's interesting because, you know, as far as, like, I was asked a question about service work and recovery the other night, and somebody said to me something about, like, do you ever do any service work? Do you ever, you know, sponsor people? And what? And it's interesting because whenever I, like, say, like, you know, like, in, like, my conscious contact with my higher power, you know, like, oh, I think it would be good for me to do some service work, or I'd like to do some service work, or, you know, like, hey, like, you know, whatever. You know, like, what's interesting is it happens. Like, but not the way I necessarily want it to, right? So I might have a very specific idea of what that looks like for me. Like, oh, I'll chair a meeting every 2 months, right? Whereas my higher power might have the idea for me that it would be good for me to chair a meeting, like, 3 days a week. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's blessings in disguise. And this is a poor analogy, but I've used it forever and ever in explaining to people how I feel about it. The movie The Craft, which I love, and I'm not into witchcraft, but it's interesting to me. They're asking the one main girl, like, what her powers are like, or she has natural powers. And she said, well, it's interesting because, like, it doesn't always work the way that I want it to. She said, like, I'll, like, ask for a rainstorm, and she said, like, a pipe will burst. And that is exactly how my higher power works for me in my life, you know? My higher power tends to always give me what I need, not what I want, but what I need. And there is a huge, huge, huge difference from that. But, you know, the thing is that when I start kind of putting all these things together, okay, well, if my higher power gives me what I need, not what I want, and acceptance is looking at the things that happen in my life happening exactly the way that they're supposed to happen, and that I believe very much that life is a journey, and that wherever I'm at in my life is exactly where I'm supposed to be, then all of that stuff kind of lines up together, and then it starts kind of making sense. It's almost kind of like a key on a map, so to speak, right? So when I'm going through something, right, I have to look at it and I say to myself, and these are like when I'm in a good space, okay, when I'm in a good spiritual space, or I'm talking to my sponsor or my best friend or somebody in recovery, you know, I can look at that. If I'm going through something, I can say, okay, I'm not happy that this is happening, but let me step outside of the box for a second. Am I supposed to be learning something from this? Like, is my higher power teaching me something that I'm not maybe seeing at this time? Because more will be revealed later, always, in my life. So maybe I don't necessarily know why I'm going through this, okay? But can I accept it as happening the way that it's supposed to be happening right now, I don't have to like it, and, you know, it doesn't have to fit into what my plan is, but if I can look at acceptance as being, you know, the answer to all of my problems today, you know, as the basic text tells me in recovery, then I can look at that, and I can say, you know, that maybe what is happening to me right now is happening for a reason. Maybe it's supposed to be happening, you know? And then the last part of that is that I have to always remember, and you guys know I'm such a big believer in this, that wherever I am at this point in my journey, like, is exactly where I'm supposed to be. And I try really hard not to question that today, you know? And it's hard. It's really, really hard for me, you know? When I'm looking at things that are happening to me and I think, like, well, I'm supposed to be over here, or this person's supposed to be over, or this person's over there, and why am I not there? Why don't I measure up to that? And then I have to also remember, you know, the other lesson that my friend taught me, that we always lose by comparison, and that's so, so true, you know? And that's one thing that I have really worked hard on stopping doing, is not comparing my journey to anybody else's, because, you know, the reality is this, if we all kept tally of, you know, what is fair for somebody and what's fair for somebody else and whatever, you know, there's many of us that, who, even though we think somebody has it so much better than us, or, you know, everything's working out the way that I wish it was happening for me, but it's happening for them and things like that. I think we've all thought that, you know, like, oh, well, why are they able to travel this much? Or why are they able to have this house or this job or whatever, you know, or why are they so always in a relationship and I can't find anybody? What we have to remember is we don't know that person's individual life, you know? And so we're always going to lose by comparison because we're always going to see us as having less than. So when I put all of those things together, you know, it's like a good reminder for me to kind of like evaluate the situation that I'm at in my life at that moment, you know. So this meditation is really, really good. And I think it's important for us to ask for what we need. But I think also we have to be really careful about what are we really asking for? Like, And this is dangerous, because when I say this, it's like people will be like, well, yeah, I do want to win the lottery, you know? But like when you're saying, you know, like, God, let me win the lottery, like, are you really asking for to win the lottery? Or are you just asking to be financially stable? Are you just asking to pay your bills? Are you asking to feel safe, you know, in your financial situation, you know? When we are like, God, I want a romantic relationship, or whatever your higher power is, you know, it's like, why can't I have a boyfriend? Give me a boyfriend. Are you really asking for a boyfriend, or are you asking to share your life with somebody romantically? Are you asking because you're lonely? Is that really what the thing is? And so I think that we really have to kind of take inventory and take stock of what is really going on with us at those moments. So things that we are really asking for, like, yes, I believe Melody Beatty is correct. Ask for what you need, but ask for what you really need, not what you want, but what you need. What are the underlying needs that we have? Because we all have underlying needs, okay? The need to want to be with somebody, or the need for, you know, financial security and things like that, those are very realistic needs, even though other people may not relate to that, because what my financial needs are compared to what somebody else's financial needs are, or a relationship or whatever, you know, is, I think, we have to put that in correlation. Like, there's always people that have it so much worse than us, right? We have to remember that. And I remember years and years and years ago, another little story with my mom, sitting actually right here in this living room. We were watching, I don't know, I had come over and we were just kind of hanging out, and Jerry Springer was on in the background, and it was like two guys were fighting over this woman. And I said to my mom, I said, I don't understand why all these people like on Jerry Springer can get like a boyfriend. And I can't, like, at this point I was single, and I was like, and I can't find anybody, you know? And my mom looked at me and she said, well, I mean, and then she said, you know, she's like, are never promised a mate in life. She said, did somebody tell you that? And I said, no. She goes, I mean, we're not promised a mate. You might be lucky enough to be romantically involved with somebody, or you might not. Some people might have 15 relationships. Some people might not have any. But she would always look at me kind of like confused. Like, do you not get this? And like, I got it in that instant, you know? And it was kind of weird, because like, once I stopped searching for somebody, I kind of started finding somebody. And that's one of the things, like, in all of, you know, getting out of relationships, I always take some time. Not tons, because I like being with somebody, but I take some time to get to know who is Peter in between these relationships. And I always, you know, recommend that to friends of mine. You know, when they break up with somebody, I'm like, take some time, even if it's just a month, you know, get to know who you are by yourself, you know? So I think it's important that when we are asking for what we need, that first we ask ourselves, is this really a need, or is this a want, you know? And Is it being answered? Is it being given to me in a way that maybe I don't even acknowledge because that's not how I want it? Well, that's not how it always works, you know? And often blessings, there comes my southern drawl out. Often blessings come in disguise, you know? So I think we have to remember that. And I think that often, you know, our higher power or whatever we believe in answers us, responds to us in ways that we may not see. And it might be right in front of us sometimes. Like, I have said to friends before, like, I don't understand this, and I don't understand why I can't have that. And they'll, like, point out to me, like, how I already have it. And I'm like, oh, that's so true. Like, I hadn't seen it that way, right? So that's why it's important also to share with other people, like, what we're thinking about and, you know, what our needs and what our desires are and things like that. But I think it's a really good meditation, you know, especially at the beginning of the new year, really thinking to ourselves, truly, 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 what are our needs and what are our wants? Because they are vastly different, vastly. So I hope you guys enjoyed that meditation and that little story. I love you and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.